been catching plays, it's like it's meant to be. I got rich in the pandemic, meant to be. Don't do too much, I keep it simple. You clout chasing, trying to make the people feel you. Boys need to slow it down, I'm talking real screw. Penthouse at the top with the clear view. Oh, look, I don't like your energy. I don't like it. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendencies. Let you an enemy. All them lies you telling, I can't let that be the end of me. No, no. Probably cause your girl feeling me. It's a flag on the play, all these catching penalties. Look, I don't like your energy. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency. Let's go. You not my kind, not no kin to me. Heard you told my girl about all of them that's DMing me. Why they hogging up the recipe? Heard they talking like I can't let Ken Wallace get ahead of me. Know your heart full of jealousy. All that acting tough, damn, this must be a parody. Okay, 101 ain't no comparing me. Okay, wait, 2-on-2, that's like four. They be sharing me. Okay, they working like the rent dude. Rent got them going. That's what I'm into. Yeah, if I'm in it, then I own it, not a rent too. No, I've been plotting on the lamb and the Benz cool. Yeah, oh yeah. Yeah, I don't like your energy. I don't like that. I don't like the fake handshake, snake tendency.
DA Sports coverage of the NFL has us on the west coast of the Sunshine State. Downtown Tampa's the spot, Raymond James Stadium. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup set to go here between the Los Angeles Rams and the Tampa Bay Buccaneers. The first 2 months of the regular season down. What will the final two bring us as we're off in Week 9? From the 6. And makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23-yard line. Start out on the ground. It's Leonard Fournette. And this will leave him a yard short. Nice pickup of 9 yards on first down. This defense for the Rams, they were excellent in that win over the 49ers last week.
This defense certainly has a lot to be proud of coming off of last week's game, because when you only give up 14 points in a contest, you give your team a great chance to win. The best defense in the league is usually going to average giving up 18, 19 points a game. So to be under that, a terrific achievement.
A gain of 5, good enough for the first down. The Bucs at 7-1 now on the year. And they come in on the heels of yet another victory. That ran their win streak, Charles, up to 7 now.
And I think that last win, that established them and stamped them to me as Super Bowl front runners. They're playing with extreme confidence. And you need that in order to go all the way.
Brady now on first down. Steps away to his left. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
Well, sometimes the defense just beats you. Great coverage from the secondary. All of them in the proper position. So instead of trying to throw into tight coverage, he found a way to throw it away and come back and try again the next down.
And he's got room. Touchdown, Tampa Bay. Leonard Fournette, his 7th rushing touchdown on the year. And the Bucs are on the board first here this afternoon. Extra point up and good by Succop. And it's now a 7-0 game. It's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. And the Rams come up first and 10 at their 25-yard line. A man who played his college ball in Tallahassee, here's Cam Akers.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
On second and nine, Stafford flushed out right to the right side and complete to Atwell. So the completion good for 6 yards, and now 2 yards to go on third down. We'll see what kind of mindset they have here offensively after giving up the touchdown on the opening drive.
And based on our time with them, you know, prior to this game, I feel like they've got a good mindset going in. In fact, the discussion that we had with the coaching staff was, you know, we may give up some points in this game, so our offense has to be ready each and every time to either equal or try and get us ahead and try and keep us ahead. This is their chance to respond to that first touchdown given up.
And that's caught inside the 35. And he takes this one down almost all the way to the 30. A first down and then some, 36 yards.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
Stafford on first down, escaping the pressure right. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Mike Edwards picks it off, and the Bucs are going to take over at their own 13-yard line. And, Charles, that's now 4 interceptions over his last 3 halves of football, because remember, he threw 3 picks last week.
Starting to wonder if maybe defenses and those coordinators have identified something on tape with what he's doing, maybe a movement, maybe the way he's moving it.
Oh, that's into a sea of bodies, and it's intercepted. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football. So a first interception thrown for him there, and that really not the best decision either.
Not at all, and that's something he did not do in their victory last week. No interceptions in that game, but this defense, they're able to take advantage of an early mistake. Now let's see if they're going to turn it into points.
After the interception, here's Stafford, eluding the pressure right, and he'll just get rid of it. Now, these two teams, you may remember, battled in the NFC division round last year, and that game was also here at Raymond James Stadium. The Rams ran out to a 27-3 lead before the Bucs and Tom Brady, they rally all the way back. But in the end, former Buck Matt Gay hit the game winner at the gun, and the Rams advance 30-27. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent gain.
They had great starting position to begin the drive, but now they look up at a 3rd and 5. Throwing is Stafford. And he's got it. That's caught for a Ram touchdown. A great play there. His 4th touchdown on the year. And the Rams are an extra point away now from tying this ball game. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And we are tied at 7. So all even at 7 now as they kick it away. This will be fielded inside the 5. And it's a pretty good return here as he'll get this up to the 29. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. Just the one misstep for them in the first half of the season. 7-1 is the record at the midway point. And in terms of whatever power rankings you want to go by, they're at or near the top of the list in terms of best teams in the National Football League.
And for me and my little bit of rankings here, I've got them at the top. I know there's still 2 months to go, and we've seen teams get off to hot starts and then fade away due to injuries or the schedule or whatever. But unless there are a rash of injuries on this team, I'd be surprised if they aren't a first or a second seed.
And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Rams will have solid field position here as they take over at their 45-yard line. Good starting field position for them here as they come up first and 10 at the 45. Play action. Stafford. Forced out to his left. And this is, oh my goodness, he pulled it in one-handed. It'll go as an impressive 31-yard gain. Charles, you talk so much about quick change plays. There's one right there. You get the turnover and boom, hit him with a big one.
And defenses plan for this all the time. They work on it in practice. But in the middle of a game, when that quick change takes place, oftentimes guys aren't as focused as they need to be.
First down, Stafford here. Dancing to his left. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away.
Well, sometimes an incompletion is the right play, and he showed that he's learned from his earlier interception on that throw. Instead of forcing it, he just tossed it away.
An incomplete pass on first down. That leads to a second and 10. Stafford going to give this to Akers. They get him to the ground right on the cusp of the red zone after a pickup of 5 or 6.
That second down play call was not to pick up the first down. It was to accomplish what they did to get him into a manageable third down because they had the incompletion on first down, so they were behind the sticks, so to speak. They needed to make up some ground, and they did.
In need of a conversion on third down. They had the big play to start the drive. Not much sense. Stafford flush to his right, and this is caught. He's got it. Touchdown LA. Matthew Stafford, 2 touchdown passes in this first quarter, and the Rams have moved out in front. Extra point by Gay is up and good, and that makes the score 14-7. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away from the 6. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started. And you know, it's certainly a lot of football left to play. We're not into December yet, but right now where we stand, they're in first place in their division, looking really good and looking to be a threat come January.
And are you one of those early holiday shoppers, partner? Are you one of those guys, get your list done? Because I think about what every team has on their holiday shopping list right now. What's the number one goal? Make the playoffs. Number two, win your division. Number three, and I think the biggest goal of all, try to get the number one seed so you get that first round bye and ensure you don't have to go anywhere in January and hopefully get to the Super Bowl that way.
Through one quarter, 14-7 our score. Throwing is Brady on third down. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Perennial Pro Bowler Aaron Donald gets the sack. Fourth down, so Jake Kamada is out there. He was only asked to punt once in the victory last week as he sends this one away. We'll call that a punt of 54 yards. Well struck. And the Rams will go on offense here with the first and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And Charles, if the season ended today, and it's not going to, we still have December left.
More football.
We're only in November. But they would be a wild card team. And that's great. They'd be in the playoffs, but you know they're trying to bump up to be one of those division leaders.
That guarantees you at least one home game in the playoffs, and that's what you're really seeking. But there also isn't much margin for error for this team, right? Because right where they're sitting, a two-game losing streak could have them out of the playoffs. So they've got to make sure they continue to keep the momentum going.
Absolutely. There's some sharks smelling blood in the water behind them. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
The offense schemed, going five wide, trying to create a chance for the big shot, and they took it. If he comes down with that one, that's a huge offensive swing. But credit the defense with a nice play, knocking that one away.
Throwing on third down, Stafford, flushed out right. Going deep downfield for Ross. And unable to connect, incomplete. Now give them credit, they took their shot, but it's going to bring up fourth down. Fourth down, so on is the punter, Riley Dixon. This is taken at about the 14. A good return there, 17 yards. And the Bucs will get ready to go on offense. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. These guys definitely hoping for a better showing than their last appearance. They couldn't really even move the football much beyond the shadows of their own goalposts, Charles. We'll see if they can get a better, more sustained drive going here.
Yeah, and every team that we ever talk to says the exact same thing. When you start a drive from that deep in your own territory, the goal is a minimum of at least two first downs. Because even if you...
And Brady going to be intercepted a third time. Picked off by Jalen Ramsey. And the Rams are going to take over at their own 41. A nightmare of a first half for him. That's now three interceptions. But Charles, with his talent, if anyone can shake this off and right the ship, it's him.
I agree, because you don't get to be one of the best quarterbacks in the league without developing some major mental toughness. So I expect him to go in the locker room at halftime, hit the reset button, and come out a new guy in half number two.
And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up second down.
Good defensive call right there, because they had someone shadowing him along his entire route. And he was right there ready to provide a hit that prevents him from making another catch to his big start.
Second and 10, Stafford again. He finds Ross, right side, it's complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. He's exceeded his receiving yards from a week ago, and we're still in the first half. It's a first down. They'll give this to Akers running right. He'll take this to the 46.
That's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Throwing on second and 8. Stafford escaping the pressure right. Open man downfield. It's Ross. He's got him. And he's taken down, but not before reaching the 10-yard line. So now following the big play, they've got a first and goal all the way down at the 10. They'll run here with Akers. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. That gets him 3 yards closer here as it brings up second and goal.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Toward the pylon, caught. Touchdown. Make that now 3 first-half touchdown passes for Matthew Stafford. And the Rams go up by 2 touchdowns. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And it's now 21-7. After the touchdown, it's Gay to kick this one away. This fielded right at the goal line. And he won't get this to the 20-yard line as he's down at the 19. The Tampa offense ready to get their drive started.
And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
Sliding out of the pocket. Man open here is Jones. And he'll be taken down, but not before they reach the 50. That goes for a gain of 31.
And this offense needed something to try and seize the momentum a little bit. And that might have been exactly what they needed. Now they have a chance to go downfield and score and cut into the lead.
Brady's throw there complete. And he'll be brought down inside the 40-yard line. This game not quite as good as the last, but still over 40 yards between the two. So from the 39 now, they'll come up on a first and 10. Shotgun now for Brady. And the Rams got him. They bring him down. Aaron Donald able to record his 5th sack of the season. That huge loss on the sack makes this job much more difficult. It's now second down and 22 yards to go.
Meanwhile, Brady's throw on target to Godwin here.
He'll get this one down near the 20-yard line, just shy of the 20. Good yardage after the catch. Is that play good for 30 and a first? Inside handoff now to Fournette. And he's into the end zone. Touchdown, Buccaneers. Leonard Fournette with his 2nd touchdown of the game, number 8 on the season. And the Bucs get a late score here in the final minute of the first half. Extra point put through by Succop. And they're back within a touchdown at 21-14. Now it's Ryan Succop on after the touchdown to kick it away. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And we'll see how this is played. Offensively, they've got the lead, not a whole lot of time left. What do you think, Charles?
Well, it's tempting to try and add to your lead, but a mistake there, that can change things in a big way. I say go ahead, take the knee, get on out for the half.
From the 31, Stafford. He'll get this one complete to Atwell. And he gets this up to the 34 out of bounds there. So just 3 yards on the completion there. And now 1 yard to go on third down. So they just need 1 yard here to pick up the first down. Stafford looking to throw on 3rd and 1. Got a man, it's Ross, complete. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Defense was thinking run, and they're dealt a pass of just under 20 yards. So in the second quarter, he's already up over 100 yards receiving now.
And isn't 100 the magic number for a really good game for a receiver? So he got a chance to really shatter that and have a profound effect on this game.
That's out to the flat for Akers. And he'll be out just a yard or two shy of the 30. Another good gain. That's now 35 yards combined on those last two plays. Stafford looks to throw again. A diving effort, but only right at the line of scrimmage. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime.
I know you don't get anything extra for degree of difficulty, but maybe you should. He's done absolutely everything in this game today, including laying out for that one.
To throw again on second down. Stafford. That's into a crowd and intercepted. It's Chris Harris with a pick. And he will be out of bounds with no time remaining on what will be the final action of this first half. So we have reached halftime with a touchdown. That's the difference on the scoreboard. As we toss it an hour or so east of here to Orlando, it's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. As this offense takes the field to begin the opening drive of the second half, Charles, remember that first half, good through the air and really all around an outstanding offensive performance.
Absolutely. They reached the end zone several times, the passing game working awfully well, and most importantly, partner.
Yeah, they went into the tunnel with a lead. They come back out with that lead.
Absolutely. NFL coaches, we know they're perfectionists in a lot of ways, but they had to like what they saw in that first half.
And he's going to take this ahead for right around 3 yards, but no more than that. Second down.
It went right back to him, but he pretty much had nowhere to go on that play.
Yeah, the previous carry looked pretty good. That one, maybe he was a little tired. I don't know.
Yeah, maybe he should have tapped out and had a second back come in and maybe make that run. Who knows?
Off the fake to Akers. Here's Stafford rolling to his right. Got a man open. It's Ross. And he's able to take it across midfield before going out of bounds. No question that they're going to continue to look his way on the game. They'll run on first down with Akers. He'll take this to the 46.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Following the pickup of four, here's second and six. Here's Stafford. Past the 20. A big play there for L.A. 43 yards.
The dynamic duo is doing damage in this one, and they've certainly been on point throughout. And they hook up again for another big play.
Stafford. This is caught. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. Only a yard of the completion. It's second and goal.
Well, offensively, that's the mismatch that you want. You want to force a linebacker to try and cover your back out of the backfield, out in some open space.
And he takes it across for a Rams touchdown. Cam Akers, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Rams take the opening kickoff of the third quarter and drive right down the field to extend their lead. Extra point by Gay is up and good. And the lead now up to 14. Following the touchdown, here's Gay to kick it away. From the six. And beyond the 20, but not by much. In fact, just a yard pass there to the 21. The Bucs offense set to begin their next possession. And their deficit a little wider than it was at halftime. Does that touchdown a minute ago change the thinking here at all?
I think it does, at least a little bit, because now urgency has to start setting in. You can't go out there and go three and out and run the risk of falling behind substantially, but you have to do it without pressing, because pressing, that'll lead you into bigger errors.
And his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. And the Rams are going to take possession of the football. And that's a ball that he